In geomorphology, we were studying different process and landform, like fluvial, aeolian, glacial and periglacial process. There is a marine process and the landforms means erosional and depositional landforms formed by this. As we know that most part of our globe means about 71% of the globe is covered with water body, and water body surrounds the lands. And it is also well known that marine process works throughout day and night on the coastline. We have already studied in a separate video different types of shoreline, beaches, coastline, where we have noticed that the waves, tides, tsunami, currents, littoral currents, a number of marine processes are at work throughout day and night. That's why today let us study the marine process and landforms in detail. Marine and maritime are the two terms used in geography frequently. Marine means when we put our hands in water, in oceanic water, and take some salt or fish or coral or any resource, that is marine. Marine means in physical contact with water of ocean. While maritime is a different word which denotes that related to or apparently associated with the oceanic water. For example, maritime climate, marine resources. So when you are using maritime and marine, you use it very cautiously. Now, how this marine process works? It works in wave form. In different video, we will see that waves, tsunami, tidal waves, currents, littoral, drift, channel are different. But here we have to note that waves are caused by wind, wind-driven waves. Suppose here this is a land. This is called headland because if somebody is standing on this land and he or she is seeing to the sea, because he or she will not stand here having back towards the sea. He or she will have face in this side and seeing what? This sea level. And in this sea level, it is also clear that the wind-caused waves are moving towards the coastline here, shoreline here. And these waves have a wavelength. These waves have crest and trough. The highest point of wave is called crest and the lowest point trough. And the distance between two crests is called wavelength. And the height between trough and crest is called height of wave. While magnitude and amplitude of wave is measured with reference to this sea level, means the distance between sea level and crest is called magnitude. Thus, the waves are coming towards the coast. And as we know that in deep water, waves are smooth. While in shallow water, along coastline, when waves fall, they are broken. Their continuity is being disrupted. That's why it is called plunge line. Along this plunge line, the water gives surf. As we put some surf in a bucket of water and give it motion, surf is being created. That's why the broken waves, when rise up, this is called surf zone. Actually, surf zone is a distance between this point and plunge line. What is this point? This is the last point of the coming wave which hits the headland and it notches some sediment or rock material. Notch is actually Hindi word, but in English it is written N-O-T-C-H, and this notching is a process. Where this process works is called notch line. Here in erosional landforms we will learn it. And after this plunge line, when water rises up, it is clear water, not muddy, having no sediment. But as it hits the headland, it causes weathering and erosion and gets some sediment, soluble or portable. And due to its load, due to load of this sediment, the water becomes heavy with the beach material, and it comes back along the surface of the earth. And this process of getting back water with sediment is called undertow. Undertow is a process, and it is just reverse of swash. Swash means when the marine wastewater moves in the upper layer of water. But when along bottom it comes back, it is not called swash, rather it is called backwash or undertow. Thus the eroded material is being deposited here up to this plunge line, and this is called beach. Beach is a land which is sometimes open out of the sea and sometimes covered with the marine water. And there are a number of beaches and their nature, and we have studied this in a separate video. This process works throughout day and night. Even in night, waves don't stop. Why? Because these waves are caused by wind, and wind blows throughout day and night in coastal areas. Why wind blows? What is its cause? I think you can answer. Answer is in the chapter of land breeze and sea breeze. As we know that during day hours, sea breeze blows from sea to land, while during night, land breeze moves from land to sea. Thus, this continuous movement in the wind causes this wave throughout day and night, and this beach formation works. And we shall study here two landforms, one erosional landforms and other depositional landforms. So here at the notch line point, there will be a number of erosional landforms, and at this point near plunge line, there will be formation of depositional landforms. There may be a question, what is the fate of now depositional landforms with respect to global warming? Now you can answer it that due to global warming, sea level is rising, with the result the depositional landforms are going under water. So this is about the wave and the technical terms associated with the wave. One thing you should note, that this is fetch. Fetch, dictionary meaning to bring. Fetch is actually distance from which point the waves are being carried by wind to the notch line. So fetch is the distance traveled by the waves from the initial point to the coastline. Longer the fetch, more the effective will be the waves, and shorter the fetch, the waves will be less effective. Now here we have to study the nature of waves. Waves are of two types. 1. Destructive. 2. Constructive. Destructive cause destruction and constructive develop landform. Which are destructive waves? If you are sitting on this dry headland and you are counting the commencing of waves, 13 to 15 waves per minute. In 1 minute, 13 or 15 waves are hitting this land, then these will have high kinetic energy and cause here erosion and destruction, because the target or aim of marine waves is what? To cut down all the landforms above sea level and bring that material back and deposit in oceans. Means the aim of sea is to level this planet Earth. That's why here high frequency waves are destructive and develop erosional landforms. But if the frequency is 6 to 8 waves per minute, it means they have not so much kinetic energy or hydraulic action will be not so effective. That's why these are called constructive wave. Constructive means they will not erode the coastal areas so rapidly, and there will be not as much destruction of physical and cultural landscapes. Now let us know what is marine process. Actually, the sea water is a type of water, may be salty, and as the river water works and causes weathering and erosion on land, in the same way this is also a type of water which works nearly in the same way. For example, here it is corrosion or abrasion. When the waves approach here on the coastland and they hit here the coastal rocks, it is called corrosion. Hydraulic action means the kinetic energy carried by the wave hits the coastline and causes erosion. Attrition means when two particles collide with each other, either during swash or during backwash, these are being broken into parts. This process is called attrition. And saltation means when water is coming back with undertow or backwash, the sediments carried down don't flow, don't move exactly along the base of the water. Rather, some particles sometimes rise up, then fall down, and this process is called saltation. This we have studied in fluvial process, in rivers, in wind process also it works. Solution is actually the weathering process by marine water. Solution means chemical weathering. As we know that when this water, salt water, comes in contact with the coastal headland, and if coastal headland is made up of some soluble rock like limestone, then in contact with that water, the limestone is being dissolved, and this is called solution process. So these are actually the fluvial processes which were being studied by river, and this is also practical here in marine erosion. Now let us know the landforms developed by the marine process. There are two categories of landforms. One is erosional, as we have studied near notch line, and the other is depositional landform deposited near this plunge line or more back. Now take the example of India. Along the west coast of India, there is erosional landform, and along the east coast of India, there are depositional landforms by marine process. Why erosional landforms along the west coast and why depositional landforms along the east coast? For this, you will have to consider its tectonic. As we know that this Arabian part, today water body, was land in past, physically associated with Deccan plateau. Due to tectonic activities, this Arabian block subsided, and here a scarp or very long escarpment came into existence. And here from the Arabian Sea, due to southwest monsoon, waves are continuously hitting it. That's why along the west coast there will be marine erosional landforms. And at the time of faulting here, the western part of India was raised. With the result, eastern part was subsided. That's why along the east coastline, the rivers bringing material from northwest to southeast from over India cause deposition. And these depositions by the rivers are designed by the marine waves. That's why here there are marine depositional landforms. We can take these examples in other parts of the world. For example, you take North America continent. Along the east coast of North America continent, which type of coastal landforms will be found? You can answer. I think this erosional landforms along the eastern coast of North America, while depositional landform along the west coast of North America. Why? Because it is supposed that the east coast of North America was physically attached with the west coast of Europe in geological past. Due to tectonic activities, it was fractured, and the east coast of North America was raised and it moved westward. That's why North Atlantic marine waves developed erosional landforms along the east coast of North America, while the west coast of North America has developed this type of marine depositional landform. That's why North America has two coasts. One, Atlantic coast means east coast, the other, Pacific coast means west coast. And these two terms have been generalized with reference to marine erosional and depositional landform. For example, which coast of India will be Pacific coast and which coast of India will be Atlantic coast? Answer is very simple. The west coast of India will be Atlantic coast, while the east coast of India will be Pacific coast. Likewise, all the continents have Atlantic coast and Pacific coast. Atlantic coast is defined where there are a series of marine erosional landforms. Pacific coast is defined where depositional marine landforms are found. There are two types of landforms by marine process. One is erosional, second is depositional. In erosional, let us start along the west coast of India. Number one is creek. Creek is actually very small inlet of marine water in land. As we know that the maximum number of creek is found in Gujarat. What its geographical region? Its cause is that when the western part of India was uprising, Gujarat was fractured from here Saurashtra and it tilted west a little bit. That's why it became easier for marine waves to cut the low-lying areas, and a number of creeks developed where there is mixture of marine water and fresh water from land. That's why fish found abundantly. The larger size of creek and the example of creek is Sir Creek, and Sir Creek which is disputed between India and Pakistan. Inlet is the larger part of this creek, which extends up to a few meters in land. And next is Ria. Ria is also a large size of inlet which enters the land, and the surface flow are the rills and gullies bringing water from land fall in Ria. Thus, this indented coast is called Ria coast. This is not a smooth line coast as here along the east coast line. So, Ria coast should be compared here with fjord coast. As we have studied that fjord coast is characterized with the indented and inundated U-shaped valleys found abundantly in Norway. So, Norway is called country of fjord coast. That is by glacial process. While Ria coast is formed by fluvial process along coast, and that is marine process also, and it is the result of estuaries, not deltas. As we have studied that the eastern coastal plain of India has a number of delta, while the western coast has a number of estuaries, and eastern coastline is deltaic, western coastline is Ria coast. Now, cave is very small size of landform, where suppose if here is limestone topography which is soluble by marine water, so the material or limestone is dissolved away and a small hole formed in it is called cave, while its larger size is called cove. Now, here one phenomena or one landform is notch line. As we have studied here that notching is a process by marine waves along the headland. So, along a line, this notching process works, and this is called notch line. Notch line is erosional landform by marine process. While here one term is scarp. When the notching process will operate, the headland will, the base of headland will be cut, and the overlying rocks will collapse. That's why the headland will continuously retreat. This vertical landform is called scarp. But its small size is scarp, while its large extension is escarpment. And along the west coast of India, there is very long escarpment. And one thing to be noted, that these escarpments are also the result of tectonic activities, because tectonic activity is the main process on which the marine process work. And here one term is bluff. Bluff should not be confused with scarp, because bluff is a landform. In alluvial deposit or flood plains along the rivers by the lateral erosion. Thus, these are the erosional landforms developed by the marine process. In erosion, as we know that, suppose this is a mainland or headland. This is hard rock. This is also hard rock. This is hard rock. In the mid of this hard rock, if there is some soluble soft rock like limestone, and here is marine process sea water, in contact with sea water, these rocks are being dissolved away. Thus, this type of topography or landform is found. This is called sea arc or natural bridge. This is not man-made bridge, because people from here, mainland, can travel up to this point and see here the marine process and the beauty. Thus, this natural bridge or sea arc depends on nature. When these rocks in the coming time will grow old, this natural bridge may collapse. This roof will collapse down and this stack will remain standing, and this is called stack. This stack, this also stack, and suppose sea level is up to this point, so continuously wave will erode it, and when it will be eroded and at last its level will be this, which will be the result of wave cut process. Thus it is called wave cut platform or wave cut benches. And in due course, this also will fall prey to marine waves. And cliff means where marine process work and headland recedes back, there is a vertical landform that is called cliff. Cliff is the result of marine erosion, while scarp is the result of tectonic force as well as marine process. And escarpment certainly the impact of tectonic forces. So these are the erosional landforms by marine process. If here will be erosion, certainly through backwash, the material brought back will be deposited here somewhere in shallow waters. And these deposits are called depositional landforms. Now take these in sequence. Suppose marine waves are coming from Bay of Bengal towards this Odisha land. So waves will erode along the coast and bring back material and deposit here parallel to the coast, which will be called barrier. Why barrier? Because this depositional landform will obstruct the speed of these marine waves. And sometimes here these barriers are deposited in sequence in chain form, which is called barrier chain. Even then, high tidal and tsunami waves cross it and hit the coast land. Then offshore bar or offshore barrier. Onshore means along the coast. Offshore is away from the coast, which is permanently under the water. Even then, if this continental shelf is of shallow nature, then the material carried back by the waves will be deposited here, and sometimes during ebb period of tide, it will be seen, and it is called offshore barrier or offshore bar. Then in the vicinity of This coastline sometimes thick deposit of sand belts are found, which is called sandbars. Only sand are here in these other materials like sand, silt, clay, pebble, cobble are also mixed. Then beach cusp. Beach is area which is neither completely in land nor in water body. And in beach area, sometimes there are circular deposits in chain, which is called beach cusp. So these landforms are developed by the depositional process when marine waves are coming at 90 degree angle along the coast. But if marine waves are not hitting the coast at 90 degree angle, rather those are moving along the coast. For example, in India there are two monsoon wind. During summer season, the southwest monsoon wind travels along the coast of Odisha, while during winter season, from over Bay of Bengal, from northeast to southwest, trade moves, causing wave direction parallel to the coast of eastern India. That's why if these are moving, these means waves, wind caused waves, are moving from northeast to southwest, these will carry the deposited material along coast and deposit here, which is in the shape of hook. So this is hook shaped, hence called hook. But if it is narrow and extending in ocean for a longer distance, it is called spit. And sometimes double spits are developed if wind direction changes seasonally. For example, here in India, for some time during winter season, wind direction and wave direction is from northeast to southwest, hence this one spit is developed. While during winter season, the wind caused waves are moving from southwest to northeast, that's why here this spit will be developed. And this feature is called double spit, will enclose a lake called lagoon. And the nature of this lagoon water will be salty. But it is noteworthy that the mouth of this double spit lagoon will remain open, because when the depositional process will try to close it, the marine waves will not allow it, rather they will keep it open. And the example of double spit here, Chilka Lake, Lagoon Lake, is the result of double spit. Likewise here, Pulikat Lake in Andhra and Vembanad Lake in Kerala are double spit lake forming lagoons. Next comes Tombolo. Suppose this is the mainland and some sediment has been deposited here in the form of island. This is natural iron, but by the depositional process consisting of soft sediments. And if some deposition of beach material is here and people from mainland to this deposited land can reach, travel, this is called Tombolo. And if there are two circular depositional landforms and these are not connected with mainland, rather connected with each other, it is called Dumbbell Island. So these are a number of depositional landforms and here erosional landforms. Now one thing very important is that due to global warming, the sea level here along the west coast and east coast of India is rising. So which marine landforms have their counted days? I think you can respond it, the depositional landform along the east coast. These will be underwater in coming days, while these here the process will work and new erosional landforms will come up. Now one thing more that is not associated with this, but indirectly, it is coastal topography. That's why we have to differentiate Gulf, Bay and Bight. This is mainland where there is physical and cultural landscape, and this is water body. If a narrow water body is within the mainland, this is called Gulf, like Persian Gulf. If the water body having wider mouth is within the land, it is called Bay. Example, Bay of Bengal. If the water body connected with ocean has entered the land having widest mouth, then Gulf, Bay, it is called Bight. For example, Great Australian Bight. There is one question whether these landforms, Gulf, Bay, Bight, are marine, erosional, depositional or none. Actually, these are not developed by marine process, rather these are tectogenic, and these lands, these parts of water, as these water bodies, Gulf, Bay, Bight, here are inside the land. In the same way, some land part is projecting towards the ocean, which is called promontory. So these are the marine processes, and in marine process, wave characteristics, wave types and marine erosions, and after processes, different types of landforms, erosional and depositional, with suitable example, especially from India, here erosional landform, on the east coast depositional landform have been discussed in detail. These are the three stages of marine process. In first stage, you are seeing that it is main headland, and this is marine water. Waves are at work here, and when they undercut, the overlying slab falls down, with the result here a long cliff has been developed. This headland is left, and here is wave cut platform and wave cut terraces, and at last stage here it is arc, or it is natural bridge. When this arc collapses, this stack is left, so this is stack, and here very small cave and cove landforms have been developed. Thus this is three stage cycle, and in these the marine process erosional landforms are being developed. These are the landforms by marine process from here to nearly here. These are the erosional landforms, while the depositional landforms are these. In erosional landform, here there is cliff, and this is cove, smaller sizes cave, and this is promontory, and this is large size of creek and inlet, and this is tombolo, and these are the offshore bar. Depositional processes start from here, lagoon and coastal barrier, and here this is river and delta, and this delta is prograding ahead, and this is called progradation of delta. Actually, delta is not the marine process landform, rather it is fluvial. So the marine process erosional landforms are mainly found here and depositional here.